morning, students. Last day we had learned about the challenges of political parties. What we have learned, the challenges, many challenges we have learned, right? First challenge was there is no lack of internal democracy. Okay, do you remember that point? Second, we have learned dynastic succession. Third, we have learned that no meaningful choice to the voters, right? And so we have learned, and money and muscle power, fourth point. We have learned these all challenges. These are the very important challenges that every political parties face in our country. And so in order to reform, or in order to solve these challenges or solve these problems, the organizations, various organizations in India, they had taken some measures to solve these issues or solve these existing problems. So that exist, that measures to solve these problems that we are going to study today. That is, the topic is how these challenges can be reformed, or how parties can be reformed. So what are the measures to reform the political parties that we are going to study today? What we are going to study? What are the different measures taken by different organizations in India to reform the political parties? Okay, let us see what are the important measures and what are the different organizations they had taken some measures. Let us discuss. First thing is the important institution, that is known as the Constitution. The Constitution of India, as you know very well, it is it established all the rules and regulation for the government, for the administration in India. Okay, everything, how to govern, how to make laws, and how everything, encyclopedia regarding the administration, that is given in the Constitution. And in Indian democracy, the Constitution can be updated. If anything we want to delete, or anything which is not relevant to the time, then we can delete it, we can make new. So that provision is given in the Constitution. So that is why Constitution has done some, in the Constitution there the government has made some amendment. So constitutional amendment has been done to reform the political parties. So first important institution or organization which reform, in order to reform the political parties, that is done by whom? The Constitution. The Constitution, the reform is given, that is anti-defection law, or it is Constitution was amended and made a new law, that is parties or the members, okay, representative from which political party they have won or they became the ministers, MLAs or MPs, they cannot change the party. Once from which party they have been won the election, from that party they cannot, after they cannot change. Means sometimes we can see the elected MLA or MP, they change the party after the election, they change the party. So this changing party is known as defection. Defection is one of the new word for you, defection. So it is made defection, this against the defection law was made, that is known as anti-defection law. That means not to change the political parties after winning the election. MPs or MLA should not change the political parties. That is known as anti-defection law, or defection was not allowed. Clear? So Constitution was amended to discourage the defection. That is the first thing. That is one of the important reform. Means MLAs or MPs should not change the political party from which party they have won. That was done. Second important reform that is done by the Supreme Court. Next important institution or organization made the reform for the challenges of political parties, that is done by Supreme Court. The Supreme Court made an affidavit. The Supreme Court has given the strict order that the part, the members or the contestants or candidates have to, when they are going to contest for the election, they have to file an affidavit. file an affidavit. What is affidavit actually? Affidavit means about the detailed information about the candidate. Detailed information about the candidate regarding the assets. Okay, assets means their property. Okay, how much property they own, that detail they have to give. Any liability, any loan or any debt, something regarding liabilities that is pending, that information they have to give. So that is done. And also the candidate has to make their information regarding the criminal cases pending. Okay, regarding any criminal cases which are pending that they have to give. So such information is known as affidavit. That affidavit is necessary. Supreme Court has made it compulsory that every candidate, if they want to contest the election, they have to make an affidavit which will be informed to the public or informed through the newspaper or any media to the public. So people will come to know about that candidate, about the details of that candidate. So affidavit, do you understood? Do you understand it? Means about the liabilities, assets, criminal cases pending against that candidate, every information that candidate needs to be given to the election commission. So it is to be, it is for the awareness to the public and people can analyze. Okay, but the problem is that present problem is that people or candidates give this information, but how much it is true, that nobody checks. That is one of the important problem. Means how much it is true, that information is true, that nobody checks. That is one of the important problem that we face. So this is the second point, that affidavit, to file an affidavit. Third important thing, that is third important institution, is election commission. The election commission has made an order, or election commission has made it mandatory. That means to hold the organizational elections in the political parties, to hold elections. We have seen lack of internal democracy challenge, right? So in order to reduce that challenge, election commission has given an order, that is to hold the organizational elections and file income tax returns. Income tax returns, how much the parties fund and everything they have to give to the income tax returns. That is one thing. And hold the intern organizational election. Election inside the political party itself, election to be organized. And then the party treasurer, party president, that all should be made, so that that register they have to keep. These all to make or to hold the internal or hold the internal elections is election is necessary. That is done by the election commission. So these are the three important point you have to remember. Very important organization and very important reforms taken by taken in order to stop the challenges or in order to reduce the challenges of political parties. Okay, so these are the three important points you have to remember. First, I have told you that defection and discourage defection or anti-defection law we can write. Next one, to file affidavit, that is done by Supreme Court. Election Commission made it mandatory that internal election to be conducted in the political party and to file an income tax returns about the assets of, about the fund of the party, about the details they have to make, and income tax return has to be filed. So these are the things that we have compulsory practiced, or it is going on practicing in India to reform the political parties. Besides this, so it is mandatory. These three things are mandatory. Besides these suggestions, besides these political reforms, these reforms, some suggestions are given. What are those suggestions? Suggestions are there. Many suggestions are there to reform the political parties. What are those suggestions that we can discuss here? Suggestions include the first one, that is a law should be made to regulate internal affairs of the political parties. Law should be, suggestion is that law should be made to regulate the internal affairs of the political parties. Internal affairs of the political parties in the sense regarding the internal disputes. If disputes arise, the party needs to, somebody should act as an umpire to judge that or to solve that problem, dispute should not be happen in the within the political parties. So internal affairs should be regulated. So for that purpose, the party should control such internal disputes or internal affairs, and party should also maintain register members for information about the members, names, how many members are there, every information they have to make the register within the party. That is important or important suggestion. Okay. So first important suggestion what we discussed, that is law should be made to regulate the internal affairs of the political parties, that we have seen that in within the political parties register to be maintained. Then any disputes arise, they have to solve it. Somebody should act as a umpire, as an umpire, and solve that or judge that, judge the, evaluate that problem, solve that, that measures to be conducted. Second thing is that parties should give minimum number of tickets to the candidates. Means 1/3 should be reserved always for women. So second important suggestion, that minimum number of tickets should be given. In the sense what? Minimum number of tickets, about 1/3. It is suggestion that 1/3 should be reserved for women. Women everywhere, they need some representation. So here also within the political parties, they need 1/3 seats should be, or 1/3 seats we can say another term is tickets. Okay. Ticket or seat, same way. So 1/3 seats should be given for women. That is the second important suggestion. Third important suggestion is that there should be state funding for election. There should be state funding for election means government should support the election by giving them money or any kind or money. Kind in the sense it includes petrol can be given, or another important that paper can be given, telephone, such type of support to be given by the government. So government should support, or state here means government. Government should support by giving them money, either in money or in kind, cash or kind. Kind here what I said you, that is petrol can be given, or we can say paper can be given, telephone services can be given. So such type of services are needs to be given by the government. That is another important suggestion. So these are the important thing is that the suggestion we can say. Suppose what I want to say there, say that suppose the question is compulsory question. This is you have to study, because one of the important compulsory question you can expect this. Means what are the reforms for political parties? So compulsory, if it is a 5 mark, you write down these 3 and suggestion. From suggestion, some few suggestions are like this, you can write. So if it is a 3 mark, it is mandatory, question is about mandatory or compulsory measures taken to reform the political parties, then these 3 you have to write. Which are the important 3 organizations, what they have asked or what they have made, that is affidavit, defection, to discourage defection, affidavit, and also to hold the hold organizational or elections within the and income tax returns, that you have to write. Okay, so these are the suggestions. Okay, so I have told you about the suggestions. There are a few more important, 2 important suggestions remain, or 2 important, we can say, ways to reform political parties other than the suggestion and other than the mandatory measures. What are the important 2 other important ways? That is also given in the textbook. Before that, we can see that one of the important line we can see, or one of the important sentence, that is over-regulation of political parties can be counterproductive. Means if we regulate or if we control the political parties very strictly, then it can lead to counterproductive. Counterproductive means what? It can, for good thing we are doing, but it can create some bad effect. For example, some political parties, if we regulate or control, the government control that not to do this, not to do that, then it can lead to cheating. Laws can be cheated. right? Means many laws we have made that can be, that cannot be followed by the political parties, or they can cheat that laws. So over regulation is not good. Okay, we have to give some freedom. That is very important fundamental principle of democracy. In with related to this aspect also, with related to political parties, we can see that over regulation is not a good practice. It can lead to some counterproductive ways, or it can lead to some other problem. So that two important measures they have given, that is, other than these suggestion and mandatory ways to reform the political parties, two other important ways or two other important measures are given. What are the two important measures? Is that party people can put pressure, people, it depends upon, or the two important suggestion or ways, that is depending on the people. So people have to, what the citizen or people have to do, people can put the pressure on political parties. People can put pressure on political parties through petition, allegations, through media, etc. They can put pressure. If they find something wrong, they can put pressure on political parties through media, through petition, allegations, protest, etc. That is one way. So one of the important measure is that, other way in that, one of the important reform, that is in the hands of people. People or citizens are the important pillar of democracy. So people can pressure, make a pressure on the political party. That is the first thing. Second thing is that those who want to improve the political party, they have to join in political party. Suppose I want to improve, I say that in my country political parties are not doing properly, it is not functioning properly, then I have to enter into the politics, or I have to enter, or I have to become a member of one of the political party instead of criticizing from outside. So second thing is that two important ways in the hands of politics, that is, first I have told you that people can put pressure on the political party. Second, what we can say, that people can join in the political party instead of criticizing from outside. So they can be a member in any one of the political party in which they are interested, and by this we can increase the public participation. You know that anything or any laws or any organization which needs to function smoothly, if people participate, if more and more people support and participate in that. So here also political party can function properly if people support, people participate in that instead of criticizing from outside. These are the two other ways other than the suggestion and mandatory policies, the two important ways to reform political parties, that is in the hands of people. Okay, so these are the topics that we have learned today. So we have completed this lesson. I hope everybody understood this lesson. Go through the lesson, revise it. Many things we have learned. We have learned about political party definition, components, features, necessity of political party. Necessity means, if necessity is asked, then we have to say that if there is no condition which exists without political party, that is necessity. Then we have learned multi-party system, one-party system and two-party system. Then we have learned about the different political parties and criteria, national parties and state party. National party, what is the criteria to become a national party? What is the criteria to become a state party? State party, we have learned various concepts regarding various states, right? Various political parties we have learned. Then we have gone through the challenges of political parties. Okay, problems of political parties, four important challenges we have learned. Last topic we have learned about the reforms of political parties, how we can reform. Three important mandatory measures, or made compulsory by the institutions, various organization or institution in our country, that we have learned. Other than that, suggestion, three important suggestion we have learned. Besides that, two important other ways which are from the people side, that we have learned. These are the topics which are given in the lesson. थैंक यू।